Hi, I'm Jeff Bradshaw with Redneck Restorations. This little truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. No, this does not look like a truck, but cooking is probably the most requested videos that I get. So, we're going to jump in it today. I've already got to start. Bacon's cooking. Garlic is cooking. We'll get on with the rest of the stuff, and it's going to be Jeff's famous fried potatoes. Or home fries, if you like. So we got the wood cook stove fired up. If you've ever wondered, this is the hottest spot. This spot and this spot are pretty much the same temperature. You lift that up and it runs it across the cooktop and around the oven, which I hadn't done yet. Bacon, cook it just the way you like it. The way we like it is we like the crispy crunchies. And we're almost there. Garlic, make sure you have plenty of butter in there. Sauteed until caramelized. Or until it turns brown, in other words. If you put this on too high of a heat, the outside will turn brown and caramelize on you, and then what will happen is when you chew it, it'll stick to your teeth. So you want to keep it on a relatively medium to low temperature, so that way once they caramelize, they're actually kind of crunchy and dried out, just the way we like them. I'm going to crowd it all on that side of the pan. We're almost there. Bacon is done. Remove from heat. Place on the keep warm side of the stove. These are going to be ready in just a moment. Back on the other side, we're going to prep us up one sweet potato, or a yam if you like. And if you don't like sweet potatoes, because I'm not real fond of sweet potatoes or yams, do this. Try it. You'll like it. We have three potatoes about that size, an onion about that size, and an apple. Now, not your usual fare. You'll see. Alright, garlic's looking done. I tend to burn the garlic. It's not getting away from me this time. So, off to the stay warm side of the stove. Do the quick heat for the skillet, which everything's going to be put in. Sweet potato first. Because sweet potatoes take longer to cook than potatoes do. Because they're hard, you want to definitely get it to soften up. So as our skillet is over there getting warmed up, we want about this much butter to start. Now I like to make sure and get it up around the side because it'll get high enough. If it makes contact with the sides, it's going to want to stick. Don't want to stick. Okay, I did this wrong. What I normally do is cut it lengthwise. Flop it on its side, cut it lengthwise again. So, I'll just have to do it this way now. This is definitely more awkward. Here you thought you was going to learn something today. Well, even if you learned what not to do, you learned something. By the way, this is a 10-inch skillet. We don't have a lid that fits it. So, get the butter all puddled up. Engage. and cover. That will make them soften faster. Okay, so didn't push the record button. Onions. I slice them as thin as I can, half them, and go into strings because I don't like chunks. So that's the one onion plus like a quarter of an onion that was left over from the other day's fine meal. Taco knife, as a matter of fact. I might mention that the onions, the garlic, the potatoes all came from the garden, and the bacon came from our own pig. So, cut up your onions, set them aside. If you like to dice your onions, you cut them however you like. Now, rattling means it's giving off sufficient steam to pressurize the inside. You probably don't have a rattler. Caramelizing again, the preferred method. Even to the point of scorching is our favorite. They've softened up. What I want to do is caramelize again on the next side, or scorch them, and we'll toss them in the bowl. They only appear green. Don't you worry. So that's how I was going to cut the sweet potato that I neglected to do. Now, I have in times past put them directly into the pan as I was cutting them up. But the problem with that is, if you're using three potatoes, you have three potatoes, or three stages of wellness in how they're cooked. So to prevent that from happening, cut them all before you cook any. I can hear the sizzling becoming less and less over there in the pan, which means there's less and less moisture in the potatoes. So those are ready to come off the heat. Yes. If you leave the pan there with nothing in it, it will get super hot because whenever you're cooking something, it's removing the heat from the pan. So if you're not removing the heat from the pan, when you go to put something back in the pan, if it's sitting back there, whatever hits it, it's going to burn it first without cooking through. You don't want that. So our oven has been engaged, and that will keep those nicely warm. So sweet potatoes off. Last potato. These are called purple Viking potatoes. You could use russets, you could use Yukon Golds, you could use reds, you can use whatever you want. Today, we're using Viking purple. They're either Viking purples or they're Peruvian purples. I can't remember which one. We have a friend of ours gave us some exotic potatoes. And that's where these came from. So, before we drop the potatoes in the pan, more beurre. We're using unsalted butter today. Normally, we use salted butter, but we were in Grocery Outlet and they had this for $2 a pound. Woohoo! Man, get it while the getting's good. So now that the potatoes are pulling the heat from the pan, put it back on the high heat. And where's my lid? Lastly, the apple. I like to cut it this way. If you don't like those things, parts of the core, you can cut them out. Sometimes I do it, sometimes I don't. See, like that one I won't, those I won't. Okay, it's all up to the cook stove at this point. Oh, that won't cook nothing. This used to be our big maple tree hanging over the house. It was dying. It had to come down. Waste not, want not.
It shan't be long, dear. Would you like a piece of bacon?
I would like a lot of pieces of bacon.
Ooh, crunchy. So now that our rattler is rattling, we'll see how brown they are on the bottom. Oh yeah. And this is where I'm going to add. My wife has made both of these, the herb spice mix and the seasoned salt. Now the herb spice mix, a little salty and real good flavor. And the salt is going to start pulling moisture out of the potatoes. You'll probably start to hear it sizzle more. The seasoned salt is a little bit sweet and got a little bit of heat to it. You can use whatever you want to season your potatoes. This is what I like to use to season mine. We're not near soft yet. So that goes on there to permeate. But wait, there's more. I don't know about you, but sometimes I have a tough time cracking an egg. If you want over easies, drop them in the pan and it breaks the yolk. So what I do is come over here and drop them in a little bowl like this. I have noticed that if you break them on the rim of a bowl real thin like this, that it punctures the yolk with the shell. So if you do it on a more blunt surface, you're better off. No broken yolks. I actually usually pour that one into there. But, which by the way, it's our own eggs as well. Okay. No broken yolks yet. Our egg pan is smoking. Oh, not allowed to do that. 2 gallons of water is boiling nicely. It's time to flip those potatoes. These aren't softening up not like I want them to. That one is. Yeah, they're getting there. A little hot on the backside. Now what I forgot to do when I turned them, so I always put my onions on there.
just before I turn them. So I put about two-thirds of the onions on there. With the garlic. And you know you gotta get all that butter in there. And goes the bacon. What else you gonna do with that bacon grease? That's right. Second half of the onion, or last third of the onion. Sweet potatoes and the apples. Season. Given the nature of it, I'm going to throw the lid on for just a couple minutes. Can't have over easies without toasting. Alright, close down the stove. That'll drop the flame back. Back to there with that. I am the egg pan. It's a beautiful thing. Alright, so remove the lid. That's gotta be good and black. Now comes panic mode. See, I broke it. Stir before serving. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's what we're after. Wipe the plate. You wanted another cooking video, you got another cooking video. Jeff's world famous fried potatoes. Or home fries, whatever you want to call them.
You put that on my plant.
I'll take it off. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your abundant blessing given us and this provision on the table. And thank you for all things. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Crunchy bit of bacon, bite of apple, potatoes are done, seasoned salt.
Don't you put that
on? Oh, onion, garlic, there's another piece of bacon. Oh,
All right, for yourself.